Yeah, we'll be looking on the multiplication and division of numbers greater than one in common logarithm. But basically, I'll start with multiplication. Now, when it comes to using of logarithm tables or anti-log table, then how do we multiply numbers that is greater than one? Three steps are needed to achieve this. What are these three steps? Looking. A. Find the logarithm of the number. Now, when you have the number you are given to multiply, find the logarithm of the number first. Now, second, add for multiplication. After finding the logarithm of the number, you apply addition to the logarithm numbers. Apply addition to logarithm to the logarithm numbers. Now, third, find the anti-log of the result of the logarithm number result. Now, I will show you a typical example to explain all these steps. Example. U three. This is a typical example of what you are going to be doing. Solution. Now, the first thing you are going to do here, I already told you that you have to understand how to change to standard. Now, here we have 12.34. What will be the standard form of this? This point will shift to the back once. Then you have 1.234 times 10 raised to the power. How many times? 1. Then you bring the second one. 139.7. This point will shift to the back. How many times? 1, 2. Then what will be our answer? That will be 1.397 times 10 raised to the power 2. Now, since you are done with that, you draw a table to make your work easy. You draw a table. You can decide to call the table this number and this log. Then draw the table. Now you put this, the first number is what? 12.34. The second number is 139.7. I've already told us how to look for the logarithm of a number. Now, let's start with 12. For 12.34, we check 12 under 3. 12 under 3. That's 0899. This is 12 under 3. Now, you write it here. 0899. Nine. Then difference of 4. That's 14. Look at it here. 14. You just check straight. That's 14. Then you add the 14 up. 14. You add it up. This will be 3. This is 10, 11. This is 9. Zero. Then here we have what? What is our integer? Our integer is what? Is one. Integer is very, very important here. An integer, this is our integer, is one. Then we have what? 1 point, the what? The value of the logarithm. That's 0913. Now, why do we have one here? Now, the reason why we have one here is just that this we converted to standard form, and this 10 is raised to power 1. Now you bring it. Now for the second one, that it is what? It is raised to power 2. The integers are very, very important. Now the first thing you do is just that you put your 2 point, then you check out for your what? For your for the logarithm of 13 under 9. 13 under 9. What would be the value? That's 1430. This is it. Then you write it out. 1430. Then difference of what? Difference of 7. This particular 7 here. Then what should be the difference of 7? That's 23. This is 23. Then you put your 23. This 2, 3. Then you add it up. What will be your value? This will be what? 3541. 354. Now you write it here. 1453. Are you seeing that? Now what will now be the next thing we are going to do? Since it is multiplication, you add this value up. That will be what? 3 plus 3, 6. 1 plus 5, 6. 9 plus 4, 13. Carry your 1, 1 plus 1, 2, and 1 plus 2, 3. This the logarithm number. Now, what will be we have what we have applied? The first one, find the logarithm. We got the logarithm. Apply addition. We have added it. The last part says find the antilog of the logarithm number. Now, how do we find the antilog of this logarithm? Let's come here. We look for antilog of 13.2366. Now what is very important is just that take note of this. This is what integer and this is the fractional part, and in antilog we use the fractional part. Let's bring the fractional part. This is 0.2366. Now, which means in our table, antilogarithm table, we look for what? 23 under 6, then difference of 6. Now, let's quickly check. 23 under 6 is what? 17.22. That's 17.22. Then that will be, let's come back here. That will be 17.22. Then difference of 6 is 2. You had 2 up. Difference of 6, 2. Then next come, that's 2. Then you had this up to be 4. 2, 7, 1, 4. Now it's carry the points. It carries 1.724. It carries 1 point. Now, let's go back to the integer. The integer is 3. Then, what will be our final answer on this? That will be 1.724 times 10 raised to the power 3. And that will give us what? 1.724 times 1000. And that will be 1724. Therefore, the multiplication of this this number using table will be what? It will be 1724. Now check this. We have equally followed this step, the three step, to arrive at this answer.